but with a little bit of tire and wheel cleaner and some sandpaper and some time, I'm gonna be able to make these white walls. So I'm just gonna see if I can make it the same width as that and just keep on plugging away. I'll cut these letters off here and this will be awesome. So yeah, homemade white walls. We'll mount them on here and then we'll be good to go. Okay, so I just did like a rough job there and just did a quick, but I'm really pleased with how wide it is. It almost, right here I gotta correct a little bit of lines, but anyways, I gotta blow it all off and then pressure wash it all off and then put some tire cleaner on there and then it should be good to go. That's how you do it, and then you just go around the opposite way and do the other side so you can get a nice clean crisp edge. And this is what the finished product looks like. There you go, white wall tires, and then I put my sombrero in the middle and I went over top of that with 80 grit. I had some old sandpaper and went over that with the tire soap and 80 grit and got it all somewhat flat there. Okay, if you look, I had to replace this gas tank strap, and then check out this, wow, look at these, made all the way from Georgia. Oh man. So, okay, so let's see here. Oh, there's another one right here. I have to do some monkey work with the exhaust because these tires, you can see they've been rubbing under the right conditions. It's loaded down. I might have to do some exhaust work anyways because we got a donut to replace on this thing. So it's no play on it now. No play. Oh yeah, that's a lot better now. Yeah, it just needed to be taken apart and turned. We'll give this a tighten. There was like six threads. This turned about six times. So anyways, I'm glad we found that. What else? Oh yeah, the donut up here. Gotta fix that up there. It looks like it should be able to come off, but what a pain to get at. Two-person job. This stirs on its last legs. You can see that there's a lot of slop. Well, you guys can't see, but I can feel it. Okay, so anyways, here's a 350 donut. So we undid this manifold and found out why there's a little leak. There is not even anything in there, so no wonder it's gonna leak. And then we got lucky because it's just we snapped one nut and bolt, and luckily it wasn't cast into the head there. So we're just gonna put another nut and bolt and put a donut in there and put it all back together, and we should be good to go and take care of that problem.